In this video, our topic is about classification of elementary particles. Before studying the classification of elementary particles, let's see the introduction and definition of these elementary particles. Now, coming to the introduction, let's see the first point. Here, at the time of Rutherford, a nucleus was considered to be a simple species containing only neutrons and protons. We know that this is the atom. Here it is a nucleus and these are the electrons. These are the electrons and it is the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, what are present? Neutrons and protons are present. But this consideration was at the time of Rutherford only. But the position at present is totally different. Now, this nucleus not only contains protons and neutrons, but it also contains nearly 100 subatomic particles associated with different energies, different masses, different spins, different charges and different lifetimes. These particles are called as fundamental particles, or they are also called as elementary particles. Now let's see the definition of these elementary particles. Here, an elementary particle is one which is not a composite of others, that is, whose internal structure cannot be described as a combination of other particles. In simple terms, we can say that elementary particles or fundamental particles is a particle which is not made up of other particles. This is very, very important. That is, it is not made up of any other particles. There is no combination of other particles in these elementary particles. This is about the introduction and definition of these elementary particles. Now let's see the classification. Of elementary particles on the basis of characteristic properties such as mass, spin, nature of interactions. So now, by the following basis, the elementary particles are classified into the following groups. See here, the important thing, that is, on the basis of mass, the classification of elementary particle is different. On the basis of spin, it is different. And on the basis of nature of interaction also, classification of elementary particle is different. But I have combined all these things and I have done a flowchart to make you understand it better. So let's start with this classification. Now, the elementary particles, as I have already told, it is classified on the basis of mass. Here, an elementary particle as always has a same rest mass. Now, here on the basis of spin, the particles of off integral spins are different and particles having zero or integral spins are different. I will explain you it later. Remember this spins. Now, coming to the nature of interactions, the interaction may be gravitational interactions, weak interactions, electromagnetic interaction or strong interaction. Based on all these things, we have classified the elementary particles like this. Now, let's understand this classification. Now, elementary particles are classified into four types. Here, first, it is having zero rest mass. And then comes the light particles, then comes the intermediate particles, then comes the heavy particles. Under the zero rest mass particles, we have protons. And for the light particles, we have leptons. Light particles, leptons. Intermediate particles, mesons. And heavy particles, baryons. Here, photons are not classified further here. And then coming to the light particles, it is classified into leptons. I have already said that, that light particles are classified into leptons. They are further classified into 12 types. Just remember this above, these 6, then you will come to know what are the other 6 here. See here, leptons are classified into electrons, mu minus, tau minus, electron neutrino, mu neutrino and tau neutrino. These are the particles. Now, for these particles, we have to write the antiparticles. The below things are antiparticles. Now, Dirac predicted theoretically that existence of antiparticles for the electron. He actually postulated that every particle has an antiparticle. These upper things are particles and these below things are antiparticle. See here, antiparticles of a given particle has exactly the same mass, spin and lifetime. They are having same mass, spin, lifetime, but they are only differing in the charge. If it is having, the particle is having positive charge, means antiparticle will have minus charge, that is negative charge. Here it is the electron, and further electron, if we have positive charge, then it is called as positron. So E minus is a particle and E plus is a antiparticle. Mu minus is a particle and mu plus is a antiparticle. Tau minus is a particle and tau plus is a antiparticle. Electron neutrino is a particle and it is electron anti neutrino. It is a antiparticle. This is mu neutrino. Mu neutrino is a particle. Mu anti neutrino is an antiparticle, and coming to this, it is tau neutrino, and antiparticle is tau anti neutrino. See here the difference between the particles and antiparticle, that is for the particles and antiparticles it is having same mass, spin and lifetime, but only difference is the charge. If it is having positive charge, the antiparticle will have the negative charge. This is about the classification of leptons. That is, they are classified into 12 particles. Now, coming to the intermediate particles. Intermediate particles are mesons. Mesons are classified into kaons, pions and eta. See here, once again I will say you, that is intermediate particles or mesons, they are classified into three types, that is kaons, pions and eta. Now again, the kaons are of three types, that is K plus, K minus and K naught. These are the kaons. And for the pions, we are having three types, that is pi minus, pi plus and pi naught. And for the eta, we are having eta naught, only one. For the kaons, we are having K plus, K minus, K naught. For the pions, we are having pi minus, pi plus and pi naught. For the eta, we are having only one, that is eta naught. This is about the classification of mesons. Now, coming to the heavy particles. Heavy particles are baryons. Baryons are classified into nucleons and hyperons. Nucleons are further classified into protons and neutrons. That is, the nuclear particle will include proton and neutron. For the proton, the antiparticle is antiproton. For the neutron, antiparticle is antineutron. Now, coming to the hyperons. Hyperons are of four types. That is lambda, sigma, xi and omega. Here, lambda is of only one, that is lambda naught. Sigma are of three types, that is sigma minus, sigma naught, sigma plus, and xi are of two types, that is xi minus, xi naught, and it is omega, omega minus. This is the classification of hyperons. This classification is based on the mass, spin and nature of interactions. And remember that particle and antiparticles have same mass, spin, lifetime, but they are having opposite charge. And remember that for the electron, antiparticle is positron. This was predicted by Dirac. This is very, very important. This was discovered by Anderson. Positron was discovered by Anderson. Predicted by Dirac. Now I have to explain you the another important topic, that is in these particles which is having bosons and which is having fermions. Let's see that now. To learn that, we have to classify the elementary particles on the basis of spin. Then we will come to know that which are bosons and which are fermions. That is, which is having integral spin and which is having half integral spin. See here, on the basis of spin, listen it carefully. It is classified into two types. That is, bosons and fermions. Here, bosons are having zero or integral spin. Whereas, fermions are having half integral spin. Here, bosons are having, that is, spin is equals to 0, 1, 2, etc. For the fermions, the spin is of integral spin, that is, S is equals to 1 by 2, 3 by 2, etc. Now, listen here carefully. Here, bosons are again classified into two types. That is, massless bosons, and mesons. Here, massless bosons are photons and gravitons. Here, these are of two types, that is, photons and gravitons. We know that mesons are three types, that is, kaons, pions, and eta mesons. We already know that kaons are k plus k minus k naught and pions are pi plus pi minus and pi naught. See here, the fermions are classified into two types, that is, leptons and baryons. Let me explain you once again. On the basis of spin, here the elementary particles are classified into bosons and fermions. Bosons are having zero or integral spin, that is, S is 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Whereas fermions are having of integral spin, that is, S is equals to 1 by 2, 3 by 2, etc. Here, bosons are again classified into massless bosons and mesons. Massless bosons are again classified into protons and gravitons. And we know that mesons are classified into kaons, pions, and eta mesons. Whereas fermions are classified into leptons and baryons. See, by this flowchart we can understand that which is having zero or integral spin or which is having half integral spin. We can directly say that here photons, gravitons and mesons. That is, photons and mesons are having bosons. That means they are having zero or integral spins. Whereas leptons and baryons are having half integral spin. That is, they are having fermions. The purpose of this flowchart is to classify which are bosons and which are fermions. See, these photons are bosons and these mesons are bosons. That means they are having zero or integral spin. This is also having zero or integral spin. Whereas, leptons and baryons or fermions. That means they are having half integral spin, that is 1 by 2, 3 by 2, like that. Now, if the question comes like this for 1 marks means, that is, what are photons means, you can directly say, it is having zero rest mass and it is a boson. That means it is having zero or integral spin. If the question is about leptons means, you can say that these are light particles which are fermions. That means they are having half integral spin. Remember that photons and mesons are bosons and leptons and baryons are fermions. I hope you all understood this classification very well.
By this following explanation, you should understand that the structure of nucleus is very, very complex. That is, in the nucleus, not only proton and neutrons are present, but there are nearly 100 elementary particles. No theory has yet been developed to account for the origin of nearly 100 particles. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel.